Good morning, student. Today we will start with next chapter in the form of business organization, that is cooperative society or cooperative organization. As a word is there, cooperative means bringing all the people together and they should cooperate. So cooperative society refers to that voluntary association of persons who join together with the motive of welfare of the members. The basic principle of cooperation is inherited in the statement each for all and all for each. Now, in the words of Professor H. Calvert, cooperation is a form of organization wherein persons voluntarily associate together as human beings on the basis of equality for the promotion of the economic interests of themselves. According to international law organization, a cooperative society is an association of persons, usually of limited means, who have voluntarily joined together to achieve a common economic and through the formation of democratically controlled business organizations, making equitable contribution to the capital required and accepting a fair share of risk and benefits of the undertaking. Now, feature or characteristic of business cooperative organization, firstly, registration. Cooperative organizations are registered under the Cooperative Societies Act 1912. All the activities of organization are run according to the provisions of this act. They have separate identity. How? After registration, it becomes an artificial person. After registration, the identity of a cooperative society is separate from its member. A cooperative society signs contract in its own name and can file a case against other. It has a perpetual succession and common seal. Anyone can go, anyone can come. The show will go on. Voluntary association. Cooperative society form of organization is a voluntary association of persons who are at least 18 years, means major, of age and have a common interest. A person can join and leave cooperative society at any time according to free will. The members of cooperative society is open and not restricted, and there is no discrimination on the basis of caste, color, creed or religion. Then democratic management. In case of cooperative society, one person has one vote irrespective of number of shares held by him. No matter how powerful he is, but he has only one vote. So one man, one vote is the principle of cooperative. Hence, there is a complete democratic setup in the management, and all the decisions are taken by the members of the society on the basis of majority. Service motive. Main motive of cooperative society is to provide service to its members. Surplus, if generated, distributed as members among members according to laws of society. Limited liability. Liability of members of society is limited to the amount contributed by them as capital in the society. Their personal assets cannot be used to pay off the debts of the society. Like, take an example, Amul. Amul Doodh Peeta in India. Amul is a cooperative society and it's one of the largest cooperative society. It's the society behind white revolution, that is milk products. Same in UP, it's Parag Doodh Society. In Uttarachal, it's Aachal Doodh Society. Or in Delhi, Mother Dairy. So these are all societies which are run for upliftment of the societies. So these are cooperative societies, example of cooperative societies. Thank you.